Hey guys, today is our topic about the female reproductive system anatomy. Female reproductive system consists of the external organs and internal organs. External organs of the female reproductive system consist of the hymen, vulva, labia majora and the labia minora, clitoris and bulbous cordis. External organs consist of hymen, vulva, labia majora, labia minora, clitoris and bulbous cordis. If we come to the internal organs of the female reproductive system, first of all, we will discuss about the ovary. Ovary is made up of the simple cuboidal epithelial tissue or the germinal epithelial tissue. Ovary having to the two layers, the outer layer of the ovary is made up, is called the cortex. Ovary is made up of two layers. The outer one is called the cortex, the inner one is called medulla. In the cortex of the ovary, there's present of the primordial follicles. These primordial follicles are not mature until the puberty. Why these primordial follicles are not matured until the puberty? The reason behind this, if I show here a primordial follicle, for example, this one is a primordial follicle, and this cell are the granulosa cell. Around the primordial follicle, these specific cell are known as a granulosa cells. These granulosa cells have specific types of the factors which inhibit the maturation of the primordial follicles into formation of the ovum until the puberty. But when the puberty occurs, then the ovum is produced. When the ovum will be produced, then this ovum will enter into the fallopian tube. Fallopian tube consists of three parts. The first main part of the fallopian tube is known as the infundibulum. The first part, this one is the infundibulum. This broad and widest part of the fallopian tube is known as a ampulla. The last part is known as a isthmus. So the fallopian tube consists of three parts. First part of the fallopian tube is known as a infundibulum. Second part, which is a broad and the wide part, this known as a ampulla. And the third part is known as a isthmus, which is a narrow part. Fallopian tube is made up of the simple columnar ciliated tissue. Why this is made up of the ciliated tissue? For this reason, we should know about the ovum. Ovum is a non-motile. Ovum is a non-motile. It means that ovum can't move itself. For the movement of the ovum, we need of the cilia. So this fallopian tube is made up of the ciliated structure or the ciliated epithelial tissue. This ovum will enter into the fallopian tube, and this structure is called the fimbriae. This ovum will enter into the fallopian tube with the help of the fimbriae, and this is the place where the fertilization occurred. If someone asks a question that why the fertilization occurred into the ampulla, the reason is this: because in the fallopian tube, only the ampulla is the wide and the broad part, so the fertilization occurs into the ampullary region. We can see this one is a narrow part, and we come here, this one is the broad part, and this one is called the ampulla, and last one, this is the isthmus. So when the fertilization occurs, this form of the zygote, and we have discussed about the ovary, fallopian tube. Now we will discuss about the uterus. If we come here to the uterus consists of mainly of three parts. The upper part, even to above to the fallopian tube, the upper part is known as a fundus. The upper part is known as a fundus. Then this part is known as a body, and the last one part is known as a cervix. The last one is part of the cervix. If you come to the fundus, it is the most upper part of the female reproductive system, even to the fallopian tube. And this one is known as a body. Then there is a present of the cervix. And this cavity, when the this fertilization zygote will come here, this cavity is known as a uterine cavity. This cavity is known as a uterine cavity. And the uterus body or the uterus is made up mainly of the three layers. What's the name of these layers? The outer layer is known as a epimetrium. This one is epimetrium. This one is the thickest layer, which is a myometrium. Myometrium. And the innermost layer is known as the endometrium. So the what's the main function of these layer of the uterus? First of all, we should know that the uterus is the main place of the growth of this fetus and embryo until the delivery. And what's the main function of the epimetrium? Epimetrium, it is the outermost layer of the uterus, and the main function is to maintain the shape and the size of the uterus. Myometrium provide the nutrition to this fetus when the this zygote type of the when it's implanted here, the main function of the myometrium is to provide of the uterus. And the near to the delivery, there's present also a specific type of the oxytocin receptor. What's the main function of the oxytocin? The oxytocin causes the contraction of the uterus, uterine cavity or the uterus. It's caused to the contraction when the these having to the specific this myometrium having the oxytocin receptors at the time near to the delivery, so the uterus will be contract, then this baby will be pushed down. And if we come to the endometrium, first of all, we should know about the endometrium. Endometrium is made up of the two main layers. The first layer of the endometrium is the functional layer, and the second one is the basal layer. For example, if fertilization not occur, this whole mechanism is not happening here. Then this ovum will come here. Reach at this place, and this place is known as the endometrium. What's the main function of the endometrium? The endometrium nearly about of the 28 days of the menstrual cycle. With the help of the release of the progesterone hormone, luteinizing hormone, this will increase in size. And when this will increase in size and near to the 28 days, this the functional layer of the endometrium will be sloughed off. So when will be this sloughed off and endometrium, then the only basal layer will be into the endometrium. Then this basal layer have to regenerate, have a capacity to regenerate of the functional layer. What's endometrium consists of the two layers. First layer is known as a functional layer, which also have the spiral arteries. So when fertilization not occur, then this will ovum will degraded. When fertilization not occur, then this ovum will also degeneration occurs, and endometrium of the spiral arteries, this will also cause to the degeneration of the spiral arteries and the slough down of the endometrium thick layers. So this all fluid and the all material will come out in the through the vagina, and this need of the nearly about of the 28 days. And then we come to the cervix. Then we come to the cervix. The cervix, the opening of the cervix is known as a os. The opening of the cervix is known as a os. Basically, cervix has a two opening. One opening is known as the internal opening, and another opening is known as the external opening. If the cervix have the opening toward the uterus, then it's known as the internal os. First of all, you should know that the opening of the os, the opening of the cervix is known as a os. If the opening toward the uterus, then it's known as a internal os. And if the opening toward the vagina, this is known as the external os. And at the end, we will come toward the vagina. Vagina is a muscular type of the structure, and main function of the vagina for the intercourse. Also, it supplies the sperm from the vagina and reach to the fallopian tube, and it is also passage to throughout of the menstrual, materials of the degenerative material of the ovum and the endometrium, thick layers outside from the body in the form of the bleeding, and this process is also known as the ovulation or the menstrual cycle period.